Welcome back, everybody. Thanks so much for joining me. Today we're going to be on the Mac, so we're not going to be looking at my face for very long, but I just want to do an intro to this video. This video is all about how to mask fur in Photoshop. So essentially what I'm hoping you go away from this video knowing is how to mask fur, hair, coat, fluff, whatever you want to call it, how to mask it well, quickly, properly. The reason why I've not included this masking method in previous videos is because, to be fair, it needs a whole video by itself, which is why I'm going to cover it now. So in any previous video that I've done, you've probably seen me free mask, just because it can be quicker to explain to people. So essentially you just put the mask on and then you just brush, which is straightforward. What I'm going to show you today is a slightly more complicated technique, and we're going to break it down. So it's complicated to start with, but then once you know what you're doing and have practiced it a little bit, it's actually really easy and it gives the best results in my opinion. What we're going to be using is some tools in Photoshop. So if you don't have Photoshop, you can't do this video. That's just kind of the truth. There will be a blog post, which I'm going to try and go through a step-by-step of this as well in the description below. And if you haven't already, please do press the subscribe button and click the bell icon. The bell icon helps you out because it gives you notification every single time I upload a video. I upload every week and sometimes one night if I feel like it. That's bright, that, isn't it? Blinded myself. Without further ado, let's get stuck in. Show you that's how it came in. This is where we're at now. And I want to just add some movable color to the situation. So I've just created an action to speed this up. So you can see that's banged a movable color block over there. And what I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna sort of position that where I think it should be. And I'm just gonna increase the opacity of it so that it's super obvious. Now, obviously we can't leave that like that because it looks ridiculous. So how are we gonna go ahead and mask him out? This technique that I'm gonna show you does take a bit of practice, but I'm gonna just show you because I think it's 100% worth knowing. So you wanna click on your active layer, your one with your subject on. And then the next step is to go up to the top, click select and click subject. Now, Photoshop usually does a pretty good job at selecting the general subject area. As you can see, we're missing some of his outsides, but other than that, the general selection is correct. So when you've got that, and if it's not totally horrific, go select and then select a mask. Within the select a mask module, you've got loads of different tools, and this is where things can start to go a bit wrong. Now, my preferred view for the overlay option is to use overlay because I think it's easier to see. I set my opacity pretty, you know, high up, not anything massive, and I just have high quality preview selected. If you've got a computer that doesn't have a lot of RAM available in it and the CPU's maybe not very new, you might want to click off of high quality preview. My Mac is running with 68 gig of RAM. I've only got 3.18 left, but that is enormous. So don't overcook your computer because that's not good for anybody. You want to make sure that at the moment your global refinements are all kind of at zero and your shift edge is at zero. Edge detection, again, is at zero. Now, what edge detection is, basically that's detecting the width of the edge that you're working on. So if you clicked show edge, you can't see anything, right? But if you move the radius up, it increases the width of the edge. Do you see? So it increases the width of the edge around your subject, and then you could go ahead and refine with feather or whatever you want to do. We're not going to do that. Ignore. Don't do that. We don't want to show the edge. We want to just see our current situation. Now, the first step is to add areas that Photoshop didn't do a very good job at when selecting the subject. So to do that, I use the quick selection tool, which is the top one, and make sure that it is on plus. And then you just want to sort of, you can change the size of your brush if you want to, and you just want to roughly add in, honestly, do not be precise in this situation, just roughly add in the areas of the subject that Photoshop missed out. So that's kind of where I want to be. Then the next step is to go and refine the edge. This is where select a mask comes into its own, especially when it comes to hair. And this is how you should properly mask hair. So you want to go up and you see that there is this hand with a brush, kind of a hand, it's kind of hair actually, very confusing. That is the refine edge brush tool. Click on that. Then you want to zoom in. So we're going to go ahead and zoom in.
I usually start at one side and then work round, but it's up to you. I want to start really with a piece of black or white hair because I think that that's the easiest way to tell Photoshop. And then you want to change your brush size until it's kind of like easily going to just cover what you've got outside of it. Then your next step is to, and this is going to make your computer cry if you don't have a very fast computer, but the next step is then to just click and drag where you have an edge and drag it right out over the hairs that you're wanting to mask. And as you can see, as I'm going along, Photoshop is going, okay, you know, this is clearly important, so we need to have that in the edge. And then you just want to sort of go around the whole thing doing the exact same thing. And when you've done that, I'll meet you at the other side because we've got some fine tuning to do. Do go ahead and make your brush smaller when you are doing smaller areas, because otherwise, if you go right into the subject, I'll show you in a sec. So if you were to have a huge brush like this and you were going to do your edge here, the chances are the Photoshop would go, uh-oh, and you see how it's actually masked out some of the ear? So I'm just going to undo with Command and Z and make my little brush a bit smaller again, and then continue on my little mission around the body. So whilst you're doing this refine edge, you can always go in and switch to the quick selection tool and just, you know, refine the selection that it's making. So if it's not doing a particularly good job at working out what it should and shouldn't take, then you can just go straight in and override it. Okay, so when you get to this stage and you've got your whole subject selected, some areas like this you would want to go and correct. So you can go with the actual brush tool on a nice small brush. You can change the size and hardness up here, or you can use your keyboard shortcut. So hold down Control and Option on a Mac and pull up, down, left and right for size and hardness. So you can go ahead and use your keyboard shortcuts, and you want to just go ahead and correct areas to stay away from the edge, but just correct areas that you definitely want to keep. And remember, it doesn't have to be super perfect, because you can always go back and change your mask. That's not something that you need to really panic about too much. Okay, so when you're happy with the overall selection that you've got, you can change your opacity just to make sure that you know you're happy with what's been selected and what hasn't. I'm fine with where we're at with this at the moment, to be honest. You could go ahead and just add a little bit more to the ear if you wanted to. And then your next step really is to just add a little bit of feather, just a little bit of feather onto that. You can increase the contrast if you want, but what that's going to do is that's going to harden and chunk up the edges. So I prefer actually not to. I just like to leave it quite loose, but your feather is quite a good thing to add. And you can also shift your edge in or out. So that's out, which we probably would not ever want to do with a dog, but you can definitely shift it in a little bit, and then that'll give you a cleaner edge. Now the next thing to do, you can decontaminate colours, and what that does is that smooths over the edges. Do you see how it's added a sort of extra section to it? So what that does is it tries to keep all of the colours the same, but what it does is it picks an average and puts that everywhere. So I personally don't want to do that, and also that will limit whether you can move out into a layer mask, and I want to move it into a layer mask. So I keep that unselected and choose layer mask as the output. When you've done that, your next step really is to just click OK. And what that does is that sticks it as a layer mask over on your layer. Now, the layer mask is currently not active at all, but what we can do is go ahead and hold down Option or Alt and then click and drag that up onto your movable color layer and then click Replace. And then if you turn that on, we've now got this kind of a look. Do you see? So one thing that I'm already seeing that just makes it really obvious is, do you see over here, we've got like this bit where it goes over. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hold down Alt and I'm going to click my layer mask. And what that does is that just brings up the mask. And then this is really important, guys. This is a super cool trick that you can use. You can go in and you can fine tune the edges here. And one of the easiest ways of doing that is to use your brush tool. And when you've got your brush, change the mode to overlay, okay? And what that's going to do is that's going to protect the brights. And then if you make that nice and big and soft, and just drop the opacity down to maybe 20-30%, and then just start dotting on the outside. And what that does is that'll bring down the difference between the two. So do you see the difference? So it's just taking off the lighter area. So you see this bit's quite a bad bit. So we can go in and we can just neaten it up. And you can increase the opacity of your brush as needed to just really get a handle on these things. And then you just continue on your way around. And again, there's a next step, so I'll meet you at the end. So once you're happy with the edges that you've just gone and corrected, just hold down Alt and click your mask again. And then what we want to do is just invert this mask. So I just press Command and I, or Control and I if you're on a Windows. And do you see how that's put that to the outside of the dog? Do you see? So it's never going to be this strong. This is purely for visual illustration of the mask that we've just done. As you can see, we've got the hair nicely moving out. Now you can always, always, always go back in and just correct what the mask is pulling. I'm just going to remember to change that from overlay to normal. You can always go back and just fine tune the mask. Nothing is ever fixed in this kind of a situation, so you can always just go in and rework specific sections if you think that it would be beneficial. You can always also, if you wanted to, refine the edges by going ahead and grabbing the splitting off this layer into two sections and then just grabbing the edge of it. And then working through and fit, you could fill in the mask edges, if that makes sense, by selecting just what's on the edge. And then what that does is that will make sure that you can just go around, fill in with a brush. So what I'm doing at the moment, because this is movable color, is I'm just softening off any edges, because anything that's not the main subject, it doesn't matter if there is some of that movable color spilling out onto the subject's hair. And what I actually want to do is just go on a really low opacity and just drop some in over this top bit, because that's more realistic coming in over the top. You can also shape that into the ear sections, and then we will go ahead and drop that right back down. And then what I like to do, because I'm quite happy with this mask, is I will just make a new layer with this gradient and then turn that layer off. And then I know I've got that mask saved, because obviously I'm also going to want to remove some of this movable color from the foreground. So what that's done is that's broken my mask, if that makes sense. So that's now including the foreground area as well. And then one other thing that this kind of masking is really good for is changing the colour. So if we were to use a selective colour situation, and we could alter the colour of our greens in the image, and we could also do the same if we wanted to for the yellows, to make it look a little bit warmer. So I mean, that's kind of it, guys. Some dogs it works really well for. Alf's a bit difficult because he's got the grey around the ears, which makes it a bit difficult. If he was, say, for example, a Vizsla, so very orange on a very green or very light background, this would be so easy to do. So you just want to go in and fine tune. It depends on the use as to how specific you're going to be, but just keep trying, keep playing with those tools, and let me know how it goes for you. I'll show you the finished version of this image at the end of this video as well. And if you like this, please do press the subscribe button, click the bell icon, and meet me another day. Thanks so much. See you soon.